one of these, maybe at home or at school. It's a globe, a model of the whole Earth, small enough to fit right on your desk. Think of it as a map that's in the shape of a ball. By getting to know your globe, you can get to know all of the land masses and bodies of water that cover our planet, and what their names are. So let's take a pretend trip around the world. All of the blue on the globe? That's where there's water. And all the other colored parts? That's land. As you can see, Earth is mostly covered in water, with large land masses here and there. In fact, there are 7 different land masses on the Earth, and these chunks of land are called continents. This piece here is called North America. It's one of the 7 continents. The one below it is another continent called South America. On this side of the globe, we have some other continents. This chunk here is Africa. And up here is Europe. And next to it is Asia, our largest continent. Down here by itself is Australia, our smallest continent. And at the very bottom of the globe and at the bottom of our planet is the 7th continent, Antarctica. Most of our 7 continents are divided into smaller pieces of land called countries. That's what all these different colors are within the bigger chunks of land. Like in North America, but Australia and Antarctica are continents that aren't broken up into smaller countries. The other 5 continents have almost 200 countries on them. That's a lot of land. But what's all the water on the globe? If you think there's a lot of land on Earth, just wait until you hear this. More than half of our world is covered in water. Oh, hi, Webb, and hi, Bill. What are you guys up to?
Well, Jessi, we heard you were gonna be talking about water, and who better to help you than a couple of ducks who, I don't know, live in it.
Good point.
And actually, more than 70% of the world is covered in water.
You're right. Isn't that cool?
Some of it's fresh water, like what you find in lakes and rivers, where we hang out.
And by far, most of it's salt water, like what fills the oceans. And our planet is covered in 5 main, very big oceans.
Exactly, and can you name the 5 oceans?
Of course we can. First, there's the Pacific Ocean, over there between Asia and the Americas. It's the largest ocean in the world. It covers almost 30% of the planet.
It's so big, all 7 continents could fit over it with room to spare.
Whoa!
But that's not all. On the other side of the Americas is the Atlantic Ocean, the planet's 2nd largest ocean.
The next biggest ocean is the Indian Ocean, below Asia and in between Africa and Australia.
You're right! And another major ocean is up here at the top of the world, where there's no land, just water. This is the Arctic Ocean. The Arctic Ocean doesn't look much like the others in real life. That's because most of the time, it's covered in ice.
Brr.
And there's just one more ocean we should mention.
I know, the Southern Ocean.
That's right. The Southern Ocean is the name for the waters that surround all of Antarctica at the southern end of the Earth.
I'm just gonna come out and say that that's too cold for me.
Me too, we're not penguins. Now we know our globe, or at least the basics of it. The fact is, there are thousands of cities and lakes and rivers on the globe that we didn't talk about. And all of this different stuff is what makes our Earth so different and interesting as you travel from one place to the next. So, do you know what part of the globe you live on? Are you in Australia or Europe? Or here in North America, like us? Let us know, and if you have a question for any of us
about our amazing world's weather, or animals,
or plants, or anything else,
leave a comment below, or send us an email at kids@thescishow.com, and we'll see you next time.
Bye!